Salient features of solar subsidy scheme guideline 2019. Typically, 1 kilowatt peak kWp rooftop solar RTS plant requires about 11 square meter or 110 square feet area. Electricity so generated is first provided to the load of the premises, and extra, if any, is fed into the grid with the help of net meter provided or installed by the concerned DISCOM or power distribution company, I mean main grid utility. Extra electricity so exported into the grid during daytime can be imported back from main grid into the house or premises through the installed net meter and be adjusted in the electricity bill accordingly as per net meter calculation. The Central Financial Assistance, that is CFA, up to 40% of benchmark cost will be given for rooftop solar system up to 3 kilowatt capacities, that is 1 to 3 kilowatt, 40% of benchmark cost will be provided by MNRE. 4. Grid connected rooftop solar systems of capacity above 3 kilowatt and up to 10 kilowatt, though central finance assistance would be limited to 10-20% of benchmark cost. The residential sector's users may install grid-connected rooftop solar plant of even higher capacity as per their requirement and the respective state electricity regulation commission. However, the central finance assistance would be limited for first 10 kilowatt capacity rooftop solar plant as said earlier. CFA for group housing societies or residential welfare associations, that means GHS or RWA, will be limited to 20% for installation of rooftop solar RTS plant for supply of power to common facilities only. The capacity eligible for central finance assistance for group housing societies, residential welfare associations will be limited to 10 kilowatt per house and total not more than 500 kilowatt inclusive of rooftop solar already installed on individual houses in that group housing societies or residential welfare association at the time of installation of RTS for common activity. For the purpose of this particular component of the program, residential rooftop solar plant would be the solar power system installed mainly on the roof of a residential building having an active residential power connection from the local DISCOM, I mean power distribution company or main grid utility, and would also include installations on open contiguous land within the premises of the residential building. The beneficiary will have option of installation rooftop solar system through any of these empaneled vendors at net of solar subsidy amount, that is making payment to the vendors after deducting the eligible solar subsidy amount. So in this way the user need not to pay and wait for solar subsidy. The vendor will claim the solar subsidy CFA directly from the implementing agency, in this case Power DISCO. The solar subsidy CFA for residential sector shall be permissible only if domestic manufactured solar panels using domestic manufactured solar cells are used by the beneficiary. For further details, you may like to connect at https://derisolar.com Solar Subsidy Scheme Guidelines 2019. Thank you for seeing this video.